myself Raj Kumar and me as a student professor in St. Francis Junior College. Now I would like to just explain about the basic concepts of the HCM. That is called Human Computer Interaction. This is the syllabus of IT department, 4th year, open energy subject. Now I have given just a small introduction about the HCI. HCI is nothing but it is the study of interaction between the human and the computer. HCI called as the human computer interaction. How human can interact with the computer? It is the study of the HCI. The HCI mainly focus on the interfaces. Interfaces means nothing but the applications. What you are designing for interacting computer. For interacting computer, what you are designing the applications is called the interface. The human computer interaction achieved by using the interface. By using the interfaces. The interfaces are nothing but the like we are using some calculators or any MS Office. These are coming under the interfaces. Interface is nothing but the mediator. Like any system. If you want to interact with some other instance, we have the interface. That is called the you can call it as the mediators, I'll call it as the mediator also. Okay, and then coming to HCI, majorly HCI we are having the three components. First one is human, and second is computer, and third one is interaction. Third one is interaction. These are the main components in the HCI. What is human? Human. Human may be a human is nothing but users. Users are the humans. Users may be a single or the group of users working together with the computer. Okay? And next one is the and some of the factors of the human are some factors. Some factors of human are hearing and touching and next one movement. These are the some of the examples of the human factors. And next one coming to the computer. Yes, already you know about the computer. Computer is an electronic device which takes the input and then process it and then print the output in the predefined man. That is called the computers. It's having the elements. These elements will affect on the interaction. The computer elements. The elements are nothing but the input device, output device, or any physical interaction. That is sound. These are interacting with the interaction. These elements interact with the interaction. And these are the examples of input devices and output and other physical interaction. And next one coming to the interaction. The interaction is achieved by using an interface. Actually, we are having so many interfaces are available. Okay, now I would like only interface I will explain you. In that first one is you already know command line arguments. How we are interacting with the system by using the first one command line interface. And next one is GUI, graphical user interface. And next one is some spreadsheets, and fourth one is forms, form fields. By using this, you can interact with the computer. In that first one, the command line arguments, best example is your Linux operating system. Best example is Linux or Linux operating system. In the Linux operating system, we are using the commands. These are used by the expert persons only. The Linux operating system, if you want to use command line instructions, must have basic knowledge of the commands and some of the programming languages. Some of the programming languages and also we are known about the computer. Okay? These are used by the mainly the expert users. Those who are expert in the programming languages, any of the programming languages are commands and the basis of the computer. Then only they can interact in this operating system. And second one is the graphical user interface. Graphical user interface, you can also call it as the what you see is what you get. This also called as the what you see. Then is what you get. By directly clicking on that, what you are seeing exactly, your output is like that. That's why it called as the what you see is what you get. Next example is our Windows operating system. Next example is Windows operating system. Like Windows operating system, suppose if you want to interact, but just basic knowledge, people also can interact with the Windows operating system. Okay? And third one is spreadsheets. Now we are using, all are using the spreadsheets for preparing the timetables or any mathematical calculations. We are using the spreadsheet. Best example for spreadsheet is MS Excel. Okay, all are using the MS Excel. This is the best example for the spreadsheets. And next one is the form fields. Suppose if you are applying any job or if you are applying the any kind of applications, if you are looking, we are going to use the forms. Okay? It is nothing but the online forms. It's used for the data sending and data receiving. Data send by using the form and data received by using the forms. These are called the forms. By using all these, you can interact with the computer. Okay? And next one, coming to the design of the HCI. Human computer interaction design. Coming to human computer interaction design. Majorly, suppose you want to know the good design or the bad design. How you can find? Easily, well known or not well known, suppose they don't know about the basic idea also, they can access that application. Then you can say that is the good design. Okay? Some of the factors we are having for identify the good design or the bad design. I will tell you some factors. By using some guidelines or by using some rules, you can identify that is the good design or bad design. Okay, in that first one is the consistency, and then second one is enable frequent users to use shortcuts. Who use shortcuts, and third one is informative feedback. Informative feedback. And then fourth one is design dialogue. Dialogues to build console. And then fifth one is error handling. Fifth one is error handling. And then sixth one is memory. Sixth one is how much we save the memory. That is called memory. Memory growth. Okay, these are the sub factors. How we can identify that is the good design or the bad design. Okay, first one, consistency. Consistency means you are properly utilizing the menus. You are properly utilizing the menus, icons, and colors. Suppose if you are properly utilizing these items, that is menus, icons, and colors, you can call it as the design and consistency. And then enabling frequent users. Suppose if you are well known about that application, then you can be able to utilize shortcut keys. Like our MS Office, we are using Control C for copying, Control V for pasting. Like this, if you are designing any application also, we are frequently using that application, then you have to know about some of the shortcut keys. Next one is the informative feedback. Informative feedback, that means suppose if you are sending any message to some others, then you will get result. What is the result? The message is sent or not. Okay, in that case we can identify the message is successfully sent or not. Okay, that is called the informative feedback. Best example is Gmail. In the Gmail we are sending the message. After that, within seconds it will show you a message as the message is delivered. Okay, that is called the informative feedback. And next one is the design dialogues to view console. That means when you are installing any of the software or any of the application, that must not you have to know about how much amount of the software is installed or not. Okay, that means your software is installed 30% or 40% or 100%. In that case, the user must be know about the software is successfully installed or not. Okay, that is called the design dialogues to build console. And next one is the error handling. Next one is error handling. Suppose you are lying in application, you are entering username and password. Okay, in that case, suppose you are entering wrong username and password. In that case, it will be displayed as a they are entered username and ID. Username and password is wrong. Then user can know about the entered username and password is wrong. Then you will correct it and the give the correct user ID password. Okay, user ID and password. Okay, and next one is memory load. For fetching the information, if suppose your application having just so many pages, multiple pages, in that case the load of the memory is high. Okay, that is one of the drawbacks for creating the interface. Suppose your application will be simple, that means within 1 or 2 pages means the memory load of the application will be low. Okay, this factor also will affect on actor also will affect on the interface design. And one more is there. One more factor. Suppose if you want to close the application, that is called the internal locus of. Suppose if you want to close the application, it will not directly close. It is asking for the if you want to close the application or not. Like this is the one window, in that window, it is asking for the if you really want to close the application or not. Like that message is asked. Yes or no. Like this window. The booty interface. This is about the how we are